Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. Mr. Deputy Chairman, Sir, I welcome this will which has been moved by the Honorable Minister. This is a will which has got the consent of the important organizations of the scheduled castes and of the scheduled tribes, and as such it is in the fitness of things that we should try to respond to the desire of those organizations and their representatives. Sir, the sentiment of those organizations is quite understandable, because in the arrangement as it exists at present, those members of the scheduled castes and the scheduled tribes who want to take advantage of the reservation made for them in the constitution in order to represent certain constituencies in the legislatures and laboring under a distinct disadvantage. The disadvantage is that a double member constituency, by its very nature, is an unwieldy constituency, and except in certain urban areas, the constituency covers a very wide area, and it becomes very difficult for any member to approach each and every voter as he should, and to convey them his ideas, his policies, and his programs, and to converse his bot. Sir, it is well known fact that the larger the constituency, the greater the expenditure of any candidate who wants to get the votes of the electorate in that constituency. The members of the scheduled castes and the scheduled tribes are not so prosperous or have not got enough resources to manage such large constituencies, and therefore what happens in the ultimate analysis is that this member of the scheduled castes or the scheduled tribes has to enlist the cooperation of the candidate who stands for the general seat, and even the newspapers normally describe the candidate from the scheduled castes and the scheduled tribes as rather a running mate of the candidate who is fighting for the general seat. It is a very undesirable thing, because thereby the special protection which the constitution has given and which this parliament has extended would not be available to the members of the scheduled castes and the scheduled tribes, and they will have to enlist the support of the general constituency candidates. It is perhaps because of that, and because of the lack of resources, and because of unwieldiness, the constituency should be bifurcated. And, sir, there is a provision that after the delimitations, a chance will be given to the various parties concerned to make any representation. Sir, this bill is a very welcome measure. At the same time, one cannot overlook the fact that when these constituencies are bifurcated, especially because of the provision in clause 3 under bracket B, it requires that the commission should reserve the single member constituency in a manner in which there would be greater concentration of population of the scheduled castes, or as the case may be, of the scheduled tribes in the constituency which is reserved for them. That being the case, a certain amount of separate constituency principle does not incorporate as a result of the bifurcation. One has therefore to be cautious that once this bifurcation takes place, it goes, do not go further in the direction of separate constituencies, and ultimately does not result in separate representation as was existing during the British days. It is very difficult, sir, to give any suggestions regarding the precautions that might be taken. Ultimately, the only solution of this complex problem is to raise the status of the scheduled castes and the scheduled tribes so that their separate identity may completely disappear and they may become part and parcel of the Indian community as such. Till we reach that stage wherein they become an honorable section of our community, enjoying the same status as other sections of the community, not only in law but also in fact, this type of protection will become necessary, and as long as this protection is necessary, certain risks will have to be taken with regard to the separation and reservation of constituencies for these weaker sections of our community. Therefore, while the risks are there, this particular bill is in response to the wishes of the people concerned and therefore has to be welcomed. Sir, one word more regarding the amendment of my friend, and I have done. That amendment seeks, and therefore the delimitation takes place, a committee should be appointed to advise the election commission in the manner in which this delimitation should take place. I am afraid, sir, I am not in agreement with the suggestion made therein. Ultimately, we have to trust the election commission as an impartial body. They will be guided by the instructions that have already been given in this bill and will do its best to act according to these instructions. If we do not trust the election commission, democracy in this country will not be able to flourish at all. Therefore, it is desirable that the question of delimitation should be left to this impartial एंड ऑटोनोमस कमीशन. द इलेक्शन कमीशन विच इज इन चार्ज ऑफ इलेक्शन मैटर्स एट द सेंटर एंड इन द स्टेट्स फुल स्टॉप.